Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Sam. I hope you guys are having an amazing day. As you guys can see in the title for today's video, I have my 2019 yearly favorites. This is the first year that I've actually decided to do this. And just because I know that I didn't do consistent like favorites video throughout the year, I wanted to do a video where I actually go through all of the favorites for the year. Now, I don't change my makeup a lot. Once I like find something that I like, I'll stick to it for a long period of time. So like I didn't try a lot of things, but if this is the first video that you have stumbled upon my channel, then it is going to be like new things to you. Before we get started, please don't forget to subscribe in the little button down there. And if you want to know what my 2019 yearly favorites were, then just keep on watching. Okay, so I'm going to start off with primers. And the first primer I have here, this is the Milk Makeup Hydro Grip Primer. And as you guys can tell by the bottle, I have used this throughout the year. And I still have a little bit up here, if you guys can see. I still have a little bit. I actually bought this at the beginning of 2019. And it has lasted me more than a year. It is my favorite primer by far. I do have oily to normal skin, and I tend to get oily throughout the day, but this milk, since I discovered this primer, it has really helped my foundation last throughout the day, kind of like a glue. So once you apply it, it's gonna get a little tacky, and that's the perfect like consistency that you want it to be. For you to apply your makeup on it, and it'll help your foundation last throughout the day. Whenever I forget to use this primer, I tend to get a little bit more oily than when I do use it. So if you are oily to combo skin, I do definitely recommend this primer. Go actually into Sephora and ask for a sample, and they give you a pretty nice sample, and you can just try it throughout the days and see how you like it. By far, it's actually like one of my favorite primers. The next primer I have, this is the Maybelline Master Prime by Face Studio. And this is actually the green one. I've actually used this one for years, and it actually really helps with my redness. I actually have a lot of redness right here, like underneath all this makeup. I have a lot of redness, and this actually helps blur and just like take away that redness for my foundation to be applied on evenly. The next primer I have here, this is the e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer. And I actually discovered this through Jeffree Star. I'm pretty sure everybody like discovered this through him, because he did a comparison video with the Tatcha one, I believe. And I use it every single day. It helps my pores like minimize. I have a lot, like my pores are a little bit bigger on like my cheek area right here, and like for me, my everyday combo for my foundation is this, and it like makes it last throughout the day. My skin looks perfect with this. Like I've actually asked, like people have asked me like what I'm wearing as a foundation, because it just makes my skin look so smooth. I literally have like no pores whenever I wear this primer. Sometimes I would, if I'm not wearing any makeup that day, I would just wear this one, and just to like, you know, disappear those pores a little bit. And it works wonders even if you're not wearing a lot of, like even if you're not wearing any makeup, your skin looks perfect, like airbrush perfect. Next up, I have my foundations for the year, and I'm actually gonna just mention one foundation and the other one I ran out. I didn't buy it again. It is a high-end foundation. It's the Urban Decay Naked Foundation, or Stay Naked Foundation. By far one of my favorite foundations. It's an amazing coverage. You can definitely do it medium and like build it up to full coverage. You have oily skin, it is an amazing high-end foundation. So it really like tames my oils throughout the day. I really, really liked it. The next foundation I talk about is like my all-time favorite foundation. This is the NYX Can't Stop, Won't Stop Full Coverage Foundation. And I think I raved about this foundation so much throughout the year and like different favorites video, because it's just such an amazing foundation. I pick mine up usually like at Ulta, because they do have a larger selection of colors or shades. For sure, it's my like the by far my favorite foundation. It is drugstore, which is nice. And if you have oily skin, you have to try this foundation. There's days that I actually like don't set it, and it just like stays in place throughout the day. It tames all of my oils. I actually noticed that the only place that I get really, really oily is my nose. And I noticed that with this foundation, it hardly gets oily. Even on days that I forget to like set my face, just notice that my foundation like lasts throughout the day. Even on days that I have to wear my face for like 10 to 12 hours. Sometimes throughout, like at the end of the day, like around 8, I would notice a little bit of oils coming through. I don't have to carry around my powder worrying that I'm gonna get oily. So that is a must for me. Okay, next I have concealers, and I have my one and true love. This is the Tarte Shape Tape. I'm pretty sure you guys have heard about this concealer. A lot of people don't like it because it tends to be a little bit more on the heavy side, but I actually find it that I don't know, it makes me look very awake. It is very full coverage. It's a very thick, like, consistency that it has. And I actually picked up the e.l.f. Cameo concealer the other day, and I want to say it's not a, like, exact dupe, because I do feel this is a little bit more sheer than this one, just a tiny bit, but it's definitely, like, comparable to the Shape Tape. But yeah, this is by far, like, my favorite concealer ever. Next, I have my two powders that I use to set my face. The first one is the Studio MAC Fix powder foundation, and this is just a powder that I use every day to set my foundation. I use it in the shade NC30, and it's just, like it says, it's a powder foundation, so it is going to give you an extra coverage. I know that this is a favorite for a lot of people just because it just sets your foundation in place. It locks it in place, and it's not going to go anywhere, because it is a powder foundation. You're giving yourself that extra, like, layer, I would say. And on myself, personally, it doesn't look cakey. I do not use a lot. I just tend to use a fluffy brush, and I just, like, swirl it around, and then just, like, on the high points of my face, I would just set that, because I don't like to pack it on as well, because then it can look a little bit cakey. But definitely a favorite. If you are looking for that extra coverage, definitely go for a powder foundation. And then the other one I have, this is the Kylie Cosmetics yellow powder. And I love this powder to set my under eye. And since I found this one, it's such a fine milled, like, powder that it's super soft. Like, it's very buttery, and it's just very soft. So that helps your under eye not look, like, cakey, or, like, you know, you don't get any, like, creases underneath. I did forget to mention, for prepping my skin, my favorite moisturizer is the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Cream. This is Intense Hydration for Dry Parched Skin. I do notice that with this one, it's not as heavy as other moisturizers that I've tried. Because I have oily skin, I can't use very, like, heavy, like, moisturizers, or else I'm gonna look cakey once I have all my face on. So I do find this one really, really nice. It absorbs really quickly into my skin. It's just an amazing moisturizer. If you guys haven't picked it up, I think you can get it for, like, 100 points on your Sephora card. I have, like, two more of these, because I just, it's my favorite moisturizer, and so, like, they had it for the points, so I was just like, might as well just pick it up. Moving on, I have my bronzer and my contour products, and I have three here that I do want to mention. The first one is for, like, more bronzing your skin. This is the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish Natural in the shade Dark. And it's just, I think that it's, like, a really, really nice shade. It looks a little bit more, like, orange on, like, on camera. But I do feel that whenever, like, summer comes around, it's just, like, a really nice shade. A little bit of color to your skin. I don't necessarily, like, use it every day. But in days that I do want to look a little bit more bronzy, a little bit not as, like, pale and just, like, contour, I do use this one and just give me a little bit of a glow to my face. And then I have two products that I use for contouring. The first one, you guys already know, this is the Hoola Benefit. This is a cult favorite. I feel like every other person talks about this one. Just a really nice contour shade. Like, you guys can see, I already hit pan, and I have, like, a mini one as a backup. And then the other one that I have been loving lately, I want to say, like, a couple months ago, I rediscovered it on my collection. I was like, oh, I forgot I had this. This is the contour kit in the shade Fawn by Anastasia Beverly Hills. I have the pan here because I just literally just use this one from the actual contour kit. But I do think that this is, like, the perfect shade to contour. It's just, it's not very ashy. I just feel like it gives you a really, really nice, like, contour, as you guys can see there. Now, I do have two products that I want to mention for highlight. My first favorite, this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Breezy Highlight. I am hoping that they bring it back next year, because I already hit pan and I actually have not been using it, just so that I don't have to just, like, you know, I already hit pan, so I don't want to, like, run out completely from this, because it's by far my favorite highlight ever. And then the next one, this is the Overshadow the Six Spots by The Balm, and this is in the shade No Money No Honey. I think that this is very like underrated because I actually got this one a long time ago, and I got it because the bomb was having like a 50 or 60% off like sale on their website. So I picked it up, and it is the highlight that I'm wearing today. It's just a really finely milled like loose eyeshadow, but I think like it's very comparable to the Anastasia Breezy. So that's what I've been like going for my highlight. And this is like not limited edition, so you know, I can buy another one, which I should, to have as a backup. So yeah, definitely a favorite. If you guys haven't like tried that one, I feel like the balm can be a little bit underrated. Next, I do want to mention my favorite blushes that I enjoyed like throughout the year, and I only have two because these are literally like the shades that I go for on an everyday basis. This is the shade Melba, and this is more on the pinky shade. It's just perfect for an everyday blush. This is the blush that I'm wearing today. I did apply a little bit more than usual today, so excuse that. And then the next one I have here, this is the shade Copper Tone. This is a little bit more like corally shade to it. Melba is this one, and then this is Copper Tone, and you guys can definitely see that a Copper Tone has a little bit more of a corally shade than Melba. But definitely my go-to shades. I love MAC blushes. They do last throughout the day really, really nicely. And I love that they have so many different like shades to pick from. By far, those were like my favorite two blushes throughout the year. I used to do a very like structured brow. And then I want to say back in October, I don't remember, but I am going to link up my video up here for my eyeshadow routine, because that changed like dramatically this year. And I do want to give a shout out to like the brush, because, and like the other product that I use, this is the Morphe M160, and this is just an eyebrow brush. It's a angular brush like that, very, very thin, as you guys can see. And then my pomade, my Anastasia Beverly Hills pomade, which again, this, I used to use it every day to do my brows. And I still use it to this day, but I actually use it like in a different form. I just do the brush strokes. And then the thing that like changed my eyebrow routine was this soap. This is the Pears soap. I picked mine up at Bed Bath & Beyond. And I think I paid like $8 for like the 3-pack. And obviously you're not going to run out. Like, this is going to take me a long time to run out of. But yeah, definitely soap brows have like changed my whole face. Like my routine. I just love how the soapy brows look on myself. If you guys haven't checked out, I have my eyebrow routine. I'll link it up here if you guys haven't watched that. I do want to mention the Inglot Duraline. This is just literally like a little magical liquid. And this one, whenever you have a like dried pomade or a dry like gel eyeliner, this will save it. So I just put like a drop of this, and then just with the back of any brush, I'll just like stir it in the pot, and it's like brand new. I want to mention my little friend here. This is called Freck, and this is a little, it has a little brush like this. It's just a way to put on a little bit of freckles. I went through a phase last year that I wanted to wear freckles, and I wore this every day. This was my makeup look, and I would put just actually two shadows that I'm going to mention, and in my crease, very neutral, and then I put a lot of freckles, and that would be my like everyday look. Next, I want to mention my favorite pigments. These are the Peaches Makeup, Famous Makeup from the UK pigments. As you guys can see, I have a lot of them. I love them so much. What I love about using pigments is that whenever you're doing it can be a very simple eye look, but as soon as you put on a pigment, it'll like ump up that look. I don't know how to explain it. I love how glittery they look, and how it can just make a very simple look very like out there, you know? And they have a really big range of shades. So these two NYX shadows are the ones that I was talking about, that neutral look when I was wearing the Freck product. This is Cork and Wedge from MAC. The one on this side, this is Cork and this is Wedge. And I would combine these two and give me a little bit more on the, like, I want to say like a grayish shade. And it would vary, and that would be all that I would wear on my crease, plus my Freck like on my cheeks. Just gives me a really nice shadow on my crease. and it looked very natural. So that was like my go-to look. Next, I want to mention my favorite eyelashes. These are the Celine Perfect 614. If you guys watch my tutorials, you guys know that these are like my everyday favorite eyelashes. The lashes I'm wearing today is just, it gives me a really nice fluff through my like eyelashes, and it's just, I think that they're really nice for an everyday look. I do want to mention the Coco lashes. These are by far my favorite style of lashes. The brand of lashes, they're really affordable. They tend to have sales throughout the year that really brings down like the price. Two of my favorite styles, this is Girl About Town, and this is more of a little bit of a bigger lash. I like wearing these whenever I'm wearing a really nice like out there makeup look. It just on top of my my eye look. The other one I have here, this is the shade, this is the style Goddess. And this is more of, I used to use these like every day. And this is more fluffy. They look a lot like the House of Lashes. Ooh, there's a shade, like a style, like Mermaid. I don't remember, but they're very comparable to a style that House of Lashes has. But definitely I'll link them down below because they're really affordable and they're really, really nice. And to go with that, I do have... don't have it now because I can't find it. I think I need to order online, but it is the Duo like blue letters eyelash glue. That's by far my favorite eyelash glue. I'm using for right now the Duo one, the green one with the little like brush to put the eyelash glue on the lashes, but I do want to pick that one up because the blue one is like, it dries really, really quick, and it's just, as soon as you put it on, like your lashes do not move. I have my favorite mascara that I tried last year, and this is the NYX On The Rise Volume Lift Mascara, and it's just the best mascara I have used. I tend to buy mascaras and try them and then not end up liking it, and the first time I tried this one, I fell in love with it. It has a very like comparable brush to the Better Than Sex mascara from Too Faced, like the shape of it. But yeah, this is the best mascara that I tried at the drugstore. I do want to buy the, what is it called? The Volumizing Primer from L'Oreal and pair it with this one because I've heard that that primer gives you like, as if you're wearing like fake lashes. So I do want to give it a try and try it with this mascara. And then I have three shadow palettes that I do want to mention. One, it is discontinued, but I'm hoping that Morphe brings back a very similar one. And this is the 3502 palette. And this is by far one of my favorite palettes. It just has like everyday shadows that I would use. It is more on the orangey side. It does have a lot of like orangey eyeshadows. So if you're into like neutrals, I'm pretty sure they have a very similar one. I haven't looked it up, but yeah, by far this palette, I was like loving it this year because of the shade of the eyeshadows. Such a gorgeous palette. I'm not sure why they discontinued it, if they have like other palettes that are, that have been there like for a long period of time. Next, I have the Beauty Bay Nude 42 color palette. I feel like these ones are very, very underrated because it has a lot of shadows. It has 42 shadows, and it gives you a nice range of shimmery shadows as well as matte shadows. It's just, I love this palette so, 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 so much. It's just really nice. If you're on a budget, this palette is $20, which literally you cannot beat. Like, it's such a nice price. And with this one, they have a matte bright, which I picked it up and I wouldn't let like put it down. Whenever I got this one, I went on a kick on colorful looks, and you're gonna see why. This is the bright matte, and it has 42 shades, and they're all matte, and it's just a beautiful rainbow. Yeah, the pigments on these shadows is amazing. So for $20, you really cannot beat it. I just have a couple more products to show you guys. The next are, these are the ColourPop Cream Gel Liners. And these are the BFF like gel liners they came out with. I remember that I was looking for like color eye pencils for my waterline, and I found these. And as you guys can see, they're like really nice pigmented. Those BFF cream color eyeliners. And I remember I was looking for... trying to put up the brightness. I was looking for some gel liners to put on my waterline, and when I stumbled upon those, I was like, oh my god, those look perfect. When I got them, I was so surprised with their pigmentation, because literally one swatch and like they're like that. So if you're looking for like really colorful like eyeliners, I definitely recommend those. I'm just cleaning my hand before I like put it everywhere. My last products I do want to mention are lip products, and I only have three. I have a lot of like lip liners, but I don't use them. I don't know, I've never gotten into like the routine of using them. But I do want to give a shout out to these three lip colors because these have been my go-to throughout the year. The first one is the Jeffree Star shade in Mannequin. This is a liquid lipstick and it's just a really nice like neutral shade. It has a little bit of a pink undertone, but I feel like it's really perfect for my undertone, my skin. The next one is the Fenty Beauty Button, what is this called? Sun and Lip Paint. Oh, I'm dying to pick up the red one, which looks so amazing. And the last one is the Fenty Beauty Fenty Glow Gloss Balm. Again, favorite lip gloss. I'm not a lip gloss girl, but when I picked this one up, I was just like, okay, I'm gonna try it. And I'm like halfway through it. Actually a little bit lower than halfway through it, which I'm surprised with myself. And then the other gloss I have here, this is the one I'm wearing today. This is the So Juicy Plumping Lip Gloss in the shade Party Rowdy, I think. Yeah, Party Rowdy. And this is from ColourPop. It's just a really nice peachy gloss, and it's the one that I'm wearing right now. It does have like silver it does have like silver glitter on it, but I feel like it's very like minimal, as you guys can see on my lips. That is it for my 2019 favorites. I really hope you guys enjoyed, and if you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe in the little button down there. As always, all of the products that I mentioned in this video are going to be linked down in the description box, as well as all of my social media. If you have any requests, please leave them down in the comment section. I would appreciate it very, very much. And until then, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!